The success of your cloning experiment depends on ligation of your insert into the vector. For a successful ligation, you first need to make sure you use the proper enzymes. The easiest ligations involve two different restriction enzymes that leave cohesive ends, forcing the insert to attach in the desired orientation. If your insert does not contain the same restriction sites as your vector, you might need to use blunt-end ligation, in which a polymerase is added to fill in the 5' protruding ends with DNTPs. To set up your reaction, you'll need your purified vector DNA and insert DNA, T4 DNA ligase, T4 DNA ligase buffer, and nuclease-free water. The exact amounts of these components might vary, especially the ratio of insert to vector. Thaw and resuspend your T4 DNA ligase buffer and add it to the reaction tube. Add your vector and insert DNA, followed by the nuclease-free water. Finally, add the T4 DNA ligase. Mix the reaction gently and make sure no liquid is sticking to the side of the tube. Blunt-end ligation requires a low temperature and long incubation, potentially overnight. Cohesive ends are incubated at a higher temperature, 15 to 20 degrees Celsius, for a much shorter time. Some experienced scientists find that they can get a sufficient ligation of cohesive ends from only 30 minutes of incubation, but 3 to 6 hours is more common. After incubation, inactivate your ligase with a 10-minute heat shock at 65 degrees Celsius. You're now ready to transform your competent cells with the ligation product. This video is brought to you by T4 DNA Ligase, qualified for blue-white cloning.